I'm asking, is that
do I follow the Quran?
So why did you add this stuff then?
No.
Why did you debate this stuff?
No. See, are you willing to debate me?
I am. Like, but why do you debate
he's not
other
willing.
Stuff?
He's Shamsi, not Shamsi. Forget all other stuff. But are you willing to debate
you're
me?
You're not even meeting your own
he
standards.
He challenged me, and I'm challenged. Come debate me.
Listen, okay. if you're
what is my challenge? Do you know what the topic is?
You want to debate me, correct?
Yeah, I'm going to bring
you
a topic.
You could not for debate.
Can I bring a topic?
No, why you have to bring it?
Because I'm the one coming to you.
But you are asking me to debate
listen,
you.
Listen, he's coming to you.
I'm the topic.
I don't want to debate you any topic except this
why?
One.
Why? Why are you afraid?
Because Prophet Muhammad said that as a Muslim who followed the Quran and the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah said, when you debate people with the book, first thing you debate them about, the oneness of Allah. Are you willing to debate that?
Okay. If that is the case, wait, Shamsi,
don't
wait.
Don't
listen, if that is the case, why do you debate other Christians on another topic?
No, always debate the oneness of Allah, if you notice.
No,
Shamsi, there are videos where you're on the bench or wherever you are, leaning on a fence, debating about something. Leaning on a fence, debating about something else.
The point is that you debate about other stuff. Yes or no? Are you lying? Yes or no?
Can I speak?
Go on.
Please, you two,
go on.
Calm down, let me speak.
Okay, go on.
Every person, every Christian's here, before I speak to him about anything, I speak about the oneness of Allah. If I notice he's not getting nowhere, then we move on to what? To the Bible. Is it the Bible, the word of God? Then we move on. So when you see me speaking to a Christian about something else, know that I already spoke to him about the oneness of Allah. I never spoke to you about the oneness of Allah and the oneness of God according to Christians. Are you willing to debate that?
Shamsi, okay, can I just make something clear?
So,
let's make something clear.
No, I'm speaking to
you're
him.
You're saying on camera.
No, you can speak to both.
One person can be quiet.
Shamsi.
Are you willing to debate?
Yeah, he wants to make something clear.
Let's make it clear.
That's why I don't speak to them. Because they never agree.
He wants to make something clear. Wait, before you leave.
So you're saying from now on, okay, from now on, I don't ever want to see you debate a Christian unless it's about the oneness of God. Correct me if I'm wrong. I'm going to repeat
it.
I'll repeat what you said. Correct me if I'm wrong.
And please.
You said.
Stop it and please.
You said, okay, that you've been told by Allah, you've been told by the Messenger, your prophet, yes? That when you debate a Christian, you must first prioritize debating the oneness of God,
yes.
And if it's not going nowhere, then you debate about something another subject.
That's you're right.
Right. So I'm not. So I knew what you said.
So
here's my point again. Right. So from now on, every time I see you debate, you must first a Christian. You must first debate about the oneness of God. Nothing else.
Okay. Can I speak now?
No, I have to finish. You want to finish?
Excuse me.
You must first debate about the oneness of God before you debate about any other subject.
So can I clarify that? My point is. Can I speak now?
Go on.
So my point was to you to understand this.
Sorry.
My point was to you. If you see me debating a Christian, for example, if I debate a new Christian comes to me, the first thing I like to debate about the oneness of Allah. Then, if the same Christian come back to me, I will debate him something else. But if there is a new Christian comes to me, without any doubt, the first thing I have to discuss with him is the foundation. However, sometimes a Christian will approach you and they ask you about something else. You understand? But always take them back to the foundation. So are you willing to debate the foundation?
Right. So, okay.
They don't want to say. Why? I will destroy them.
Don't run.
I will destroy them. Are you willing to debate it?
Okay,
I challenge to you too. Are you willing to debate me about the foundation? About the oneness of God?
Can I establish oneness of God?
Wait, stop. I heard you. When I came here,
I heard you say,
can you show me a scripture from the Quran?
Yes.
The Arabs are superior.
That's not Christian. That's not Christian.
But that's what I wanted to debate.
That guy is not Christian.
It doesn't matter.
I just told you, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, when you debate the people of the book, not someone who's atheist. That guy's not people of the book. So are you willing to debate me the one
you got? Can you show me where Muhammad said that?
Okay, that's fine.
If I show you, will you debate me?
Show me where Muhammad
said. No. If I show you the hadith, would you debate me?
Show me first.
No. Would you debate me?
Okay, you know what?
We'll examine it.
You know what? Okay.
You don't have it. Alright, take care.
Yeah, the hadith I know very well. The hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas narrated it. That the Messenger of Allah here. But anyway. clueless.
So, okay, for this,
come with agenda. No, I'll fit.
My agenda is to leave Islam.
You debate.
Leave what?
Islam.
Never.
Leave Islam. That's my agenda.
Watch my videos. People become Muslims.
That's my agenda.
Watch my videos. Alhamdulillah.
People said, you said I have an agenda. Yeah, that's my agenda. I'm telling you.
Yeah, we've got agenda.
Leave the darkness of Islam and accept the light of Christ. That's my agenda.
That's good.
I'll say over and over again to all Muslims.
That's good. That's good. So you want me to leave the darkness of Islam to come to the light of Jesus?
Yes.
So let us talk about Jesus to be God.
No problem. Okay. So you want to change the topic? Yes.
The oneness of God.
So you want to change
the he's talking about Jesus being God.
That's the oneness of God.
But you wanted to talk about the Tawheed.
Yeah.
So why are you talking about Jesus being God?
The oneness of God. What is the oneness of God?
Don't leave me. Show me from Sahih al-Bukhari.
Yeah, show him that.
Muhammad
said. Why are you saying that? I just want to explain to you because
don't explain nothing to
what you're doing is like you're giving us the Muslim narrative, yes?
Yeah, he is.
And the Christian narrative is the foundation. The foundation.
That's why.
The foundation of our faith is based on Jesus Christ dying and resurrecting again for our sins.
Amen.
So that's our foundation. So if you're saying it's the foundation, let's debate that foundation then. We'll debate that foundation. We'll debate sin. Sin is the issue that we're dealing with. Sin, whether you're coming from an Islamic perspective or a Christian perspective,
yep.
Sin is the issue. So can we debate sin? Can we debate sin?
Yeah.
Shamsi, can we debate sin? Can we debate sin?
Bro, I'm not Hatun.
Foundation.
No, you can't can approach me, sin? Correct? Listen carefully. Again,
why
brothers
is
and sisters, he approached, let me speak.
The scholar of speakers.
I'm not a scholar.
But you're an imam, right?
I'm not imam.
Baba, you're not an imam.
Not everyone needs to praise an imam, to be honest.
Are you an imam?
No, I'm not imam.
Baba, why are you? I came to a mosque.
Yeah.
And you told me you was an imam.
No, you know what's
why
imam?
Why would you lie like this?
You know what's imam?
No, wait.
Let me clarify something to him. Anyone that leads the prayer called imam.
Do you not lead the prayer?
Yeah, but I'm not imam meaning someone who is appointed to be imam. Me, such I do lead the prayer, but not appointed imam.
Right, but
who knows the Quran, all of it, and so on, which I don't.
Okay, so you're not an imam?
Mean, are you? He can be imam. He did prayer. Forget all of this. The hadith here.
Okay.
The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Which one is it? Read the source.
What source is it?
Surah.
The
Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari. Source. Ah, Muslim. Is a Muslim. This one. Sahih Muslim. Okay. The hadith. Okay.
19.
Okay. Here the hadith. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent Mu'ad to Yemen in order to call people to Islam and teach them to practice. So he said, إِنَّكَ تَأْتِي قَوْمًا أَهْلَ كِتَابًا. Then you are coming to a people among the people of the book. So call them to testify. There is no God but Allah and the Messenger of Allah. Are you willing to talk about the one that's God?
Wait, no, that's not what you said. There we go, go. You respond to that, That's what you said initially.
I don't mind debating.
You're the one that's God there.
Can we debate your topic for half an hour, my topic for half an hour?
Wait. It is half an hour doesn't exist. Topic first. If you,
wait, before we go to that, brother, before we go to that, yes? He told us
that tell us, yeah.
What you said, you were going to show us, was where the prophet, your prophet says that the first thing you should talk about is the oneness of God.
That's
what he just showed us is where he tells you to do it. He didn't say that's priority. He didn't say you can't speak about anything else.
That is priority.
So why is it? Okay. I just want to clarify. Brother, I want to clarify. All these Muslims, that are debating Trinity, and everything they talk about is Trinity.
That's what
I'm saying to you.
That's what I'm
okay.
So now, what is our goal? If I prove to you that you believe in paganism, would you leave Christianity?
No, you can't prove
it. You can't prove that.
Let us understand that.
Okay, but the premise is half an hour of your topic, half an hour of mine.
No problem.
Can I pick a topic to debate you afterwards?
If I destroy you in this, if I know you're not listening, therefore, if the foundation is not clear to you, you'll be more stubborn in the other things.
So you don't want to debate. So he's already making a premise that he doesn't want to debate me on my own topic, even though I give him his own topic to debate on.
Yes.
So why?
You know why? Because I'm saying, imagine now, let me be clear to you.
No.
Imagine if the principle is not clear to someone.
And
the principle, he's fighting against a clear-cut principles. Then he said, you know what? Let us debate branches. If the principle, he got against it clearly, let alone the branches, he will be more complicated. So if the foundation, you're not clear upon it, therefore, whatever comes after it, doesn't matter.
Let the viewers judge.
What are you talking about?
Let the viewers judge.
All these yes men
don't help us.
All these fanboys ain't going to do that for us.
So
what
is the first commandment of Jesus?
I'm being charitable.
What is the commandment of Jesus?
All we're saying is, you have half an hour on your subject. Half an hour on your
subject.
What?
I'm not going to stay here for hours.
No, okay.
Why not?
I'm saying, wait. Hey, Baba, don't touch me. So, what you're doing is, You take some time.
No one speaks on my behalf.
20 minutes.
Why are you speaking on my behalf? Do you need a lawyer? Does he need a lawyer? Go do it. I moved to you many times. I exposed you many times.
I've come to your mosque.
So what's that mean? I want to church.
No, but I'm saying to you, if you're the one who's exposing me, why would I come to your mosque?
Shamsi,
20 minutes.
I'm debating you, but he's just clarifying. If you don't want to debate me on my topic, I can't debate you on yours.
Yes.
So you're not happy to
let's agree.
So you're not happy to
debate you on yours? Debate me on mine.
So you're not happy to debate me about the first thing that Jesus called to. All his children of Israel, our God is one. You're not happy to debate me about Moses and Jesus and Abraham and Noah, Jacob called, came to call people to worship one God.
Okay, show us who prioritized that.
Oh, you said Paul, I said call. Calm down.
I said we can debate that for half an hour and then my topic for half an hour.
It's not your topic, this one.
That's your topic.
So you don't believe in oneness of God?
Well, I can debate you on that.
Excuses.
But let me debate you on my topic.
Let him stop.
I'm not going to start. I'm not going to start. He doesn't agree to it.
I will
you're going to debate me on yours and then walk away.
Half an hour.
You stop.
10 minutes. If I see stop, we'll move on.
You stop.
Yeah. Okay. So what's the discussion? What's the...
So do you agree?
What is our subject you want?
Do you agree?
What is our subject?
But do you agree though?
You have a 10-minute subject. How many agree?
Daniel, what's
I have so many subjects.
The oneness of God.
No, okay. You know what? If we start having a dialogue and I see people interrupting, I have to leave. Because why? I'll say now. Do you know why? Because I know when people interrupt, sometimes you want to say something, they stop you. So what is the topic you want after that?
Okay, so...
So many topics.
I'm going to ask you this.
Did Muhammad come from the line of Ishmael?
Yes, because he came from the line of Ishmael.
He did, yeah? Okay. That's my topic and you have to prove it, yeah?
Yeah, you're going to prove that. Okay. Ishmael, yeah?
Okay, good.
What's your question?
We know that God's perfect, correct?
Yes.
Do you believe God, he has a perfect attribute?
Yes, he does.
He knows everything all the times.
Yes.
Can you define what everything all the times? Know everything all the times.
He knows everything, yeah. What's your
regardless, question? If he was on the earth or outside the earth, he knows everything all the times.
Okay, what is your point? I don't understand.
It's clear.
My point's clear.
I said to you, he knows everything.
Because you are
so talk. Let's do two minutes, so we have some kind of order here. Yeah? You talk for 2 minutes and I'll respond.
Okay. So you said God knows everything all the times, correct?
Okay.
Likewise, you believe, and I believe, there's no one greater than God.
Okay.
Okay. And you believe Jesus and the Father are different beings.
No, it's not.
Is the Father Jesus?
Different person.
That's what I'm saying, different
person. One being.
Yeah, okay.
Being and person are two different things.
Is the Father God?
Yes, he is.
Jesus is God?
Yeah.
Jesus is God. Is it the Father or Adam the Father?
I can answer that to you without interjecting.
Yeah.
Make your point. And then I'm going to talk.
Okay. I'm asking simply.
No. Make your point.
Shamsi,
make your point and then I'll talk.
Okay, my point here is
when you debate somewhere like in a university, you don't debate like this.
No, you debate like that.
No, you don't. They make their point.
No university.
And then you're quiet and then I'll make my point.
Daniel, we're not university. This course speaker's corner.
I know that.
Alhamdulillah.
That's why we need more order here.
So you don't need university's order.
We do need an order here.
Don't come to the.
Just make your point.
Don't come to the lion's cage. Okay, then start to bring the universe. Okay, so now, you as a Christian, you believe, correct me if I'm wrong, that's what I'm saying. You believe the Father is God and Jesus is God. And you believe Jesus had two nature, God nature and a man nature. He is God nature. Is it the Father or other than the Father?
No, it's different.
Different, okay.
Different person.
That's what I'm saying. Okay, so according to the Bible,
half an hour.
We'll finish. If it's not getting nowhere, we'll move on.
Just put the time on.
Okay. So I'll see the time. Okay. I'm taking the time.
Now we move on that. According to the Bible, that Jesus said, no one knows the day and the hour.
Can you take out the Bible? Can we read it?
Mark 13:32. Go.
Yeah. Do you have the Bible with you?
A Muslim knows it, but he doesn't know it.
But you're the one claiming it. I didn't say I don't know it. I never said I didn't know it. We can take the Bible out and then dialogue from there. Because we don't want our opinions, you see. Mark 13:32.
Yeah. So go to Mark 13.
Interesting. Yeah. Go on, read it.
No one knows the hour, nor the angel.
I know it. Don't worry, I'll respond.
There's my Bible here.
But he knows it, but it's the same dry argument
you guys use all the time.
Always they talk about
but
it.
But of the day and the hour, not even the angels in the heaven, nor the sun, if you first start speaking. Godwin is the biggest hypocrite. He tells people keep quiet and he speaks.
Brother,
we know that.
But of the day and the hour, no one knows it. Not even the angels in the heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. So that is not the hour.
Oh, can I respond now?
Yeah, go on. Yeah.
Okay. So Mark 13:32 is the scripture that he brought. Mark 13:32 says, but about that day or hour, no man knows, not even the angels, not even the Son, but only the Father knows it. So listen to what Jesus is saying. He put man first, and then he put angels, and then he put himself, and then he put the Father. So Jesus is above man and angels. Yeah. At that time, Jesus Christ, yeah, was a man, incarnate man, where he set aside his glory for a time being, yeah, and he came on earth to sacrifice himself for us.
Yes.
Yeah. So when he said that, he was still above angels and man. So that means he was still above Muhammad himself and angels.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
As a subject.
So he put himself above that, which means he knows everything. But at that time, he set himself aside.
Okay.
Yeah. So you're talking about the pre-resurrection. Yeah. Why don't we talk about the post-resurrection, where Jesus died and resurrected? In Revelation chapter 1, verses 8, it says, I am the Alpha and the beginning. I was dead and now I am alive. If you're the Alpha and the Omega, beginning and the end, you know everything.
Yes.
So now we know that Jesus knows everything.
Hallelujah.
But at that time, he set himself aside and he did.
Okay, listen to this lie of our Christian. Why? Because according to Jesus, who knows the Father only? You told me Jesus had two nature.
Yes.
A man nature and a God's nature.
Yes.
And I ask you, he's God. Ikhwa, my brothers, I said it many times.
They're talking among themselves.
Sorry. Interrupting of you to hear. Today I'm going to expose you. I know you people to hear speak. So according to Jesus, wording, great messenger, his God nature doesn't know the hour. So he's only the Father. So according to Jesus,
that's a lie.
Okay, let's go back.
Did let it lie.
No one.
When did you say God nature?
When you say God nature, what do you mean? God nature?
You just told me Jesus had two nature, correct?
Yeah, okay.
Is his God nature the Father or other than the Father?
I said to you, his God nature is a different personhood
from the Father.
From the Father.
That's my point.
But I never said his God nature did not know the hour. I didn't say that.
I didn't say you said that. I said Jesus said that.
No, I didn't. Jesus never said that. Jesus was talking as a man.
I understand that.
Okay,
so Jesus had two natures.
Yes.
According to you, Jesus as God, did he know the hour?
Yes.
Okay. Jesus as
man.
God.
As man,
no,
he did it.
No,
man.
Everyone understand that.
Yeah.
Jesus as man did know the hour.
Yeah.
We know that.
We know that.
Jesus as God, did he know the hour?
Yes.
Is Jesus as God the Father or other than the
different
Father?
Different personhood. I answered that already.
That's what I'm saying. So it's not the Father.
So, no, he's not.
That's what I'm saying. So who's owner of the Father?
The Father is one person.
That's what I'm saying.
Jesus is one person.
That's what I'm saying.
Holy Spirit is one person.
Okay.
But one being.
Okay.
Yes. One being.
Doesn't make any sense.
So clear. So clear.
Okay. God is above your intellect. No. You said it doesn't make sense.
Can I tell you?
No, you said it doesn't make sense.
Let me finish my point.
Okay, go on.
So according to him, just told us, Jesus as a God nature is not the Father. According to Jesus, who knows the hour?
The Father.
Okay. So Jesus as God doesn't know the Father. The Holy Spirit.
Jesus as God what?
Does not the hour.
No.
He's not the Father, is
Jesus
he?
Jesus never said that. He said the Son.
Can I speak to you?
He said the Son.
The Son.
Oh my God. Why you're twisted. You're twisted.
Only who?
Only the Father.
He's Jesus the Father.
But at that time,
No.
Shamsi.
He's Jesus the Father.
In what way?
In this way.
In this way.
Wallahi, I leave you. Say, run away.
Don't run away.
Well, you're going.
I'm going.
Don't run away.
Because why
so
you're
don't want to do my topic. Yeah?
You're stubborn.
Okay,
Everyone knows that Jesus said only the Father.
Yeah, he did.
Okay.
Did I deny it?
Okay, who knows the Father? Who knows the hour? The Father or Jesus?
Now? No.
No, you told me God knows everything all the time.
Okay.
Correct? No, let me to finish my point.
Go.
You said to me in the beginning, God knows everything all the time, correct?
Yes.
And you said to me, Jesus had two nature, God nature and a man nature. Then you told us, Jesus, his God nature knew the hour. But according to Jesus, the only one that knows the hour is the Father. Would you agree with me that Jesus as God is not the Father? Is that clear or not?
Yeah, but I explained to you Jesus was talking in his incarnate nature at the time.
Are you serious?
His incarnate nature. And then I explained to you in Revelation chapter 1. No, I'm not missing the point.
You are.
Because in Revelation chapter 1, Jesus called the Alpha and the Omega. Who is the Alpha and the Omega in the Quran?
No. Don't change subject.
I'm not changing the subject.
No. You know why? According to you,
yes.
Jesus had his God nature.
Pre-resurrection and post-resurrection.
I understand that. Okay. When he was on the earth, he had his God nature.
Yes.
Was he full God, fully God?
He was God-man fully and God, he was man fully and God fully.
So he's
fully.
That's my truly beautiful. God.
Fully.
I love it. So he's fully God, which is his nature. Mm-hmm. According to Jesus, who knows the hour? The Father or Jesus as God?
According to Mark 13?
Yeah.
According to that time?
No, according to Argos. Of course, according to Mark. Yes.
Because according to Jesus. Shamsi.
Stop playing around.
Shamsi, your intellectual ability is going up and down.
Yeah. You too.
Are you talking about
you
Mark 13, 32 or now?
You're talking about Mark 13, 32.
I answered that question to you.
Okay.
Only the Father. But now Jesus knows the hour.
But you told
what
me,
do you want now?
Daniel, you told me when he was on the earth.
Yeah,
he
was in his incarnation.
He was perfect God, correct?
Yes, he was.
So what? So what does it mean perfect God? Mean he knew the hour?
What does it mean perfect man? What does it mean he was a man?
I'm always asking you, Hashem. I'm always telling you. Ask him who died on the cross.
Brother, wait.
Okay. So you don't correct me. Shamsi, are you correct?
Okay. Listen carefully. When he was on the earth, he knew the hour. I'm asking you. When Jesus was on the earth, he knew the hour.
But no. Jesus didn't know that. He said it.
So, but you said he was fully God.
As a human.
But he was also man. So he had to act like a man and God.
Are you, I understand
okay,
that.
Okay, so are you condemning the scripture?
You said that.
You're condemning the scripture?
I'm condemning the lies in the scripture.
Okay.
So if
I'm not changing
when
the subject. But you're a Muslim.
You're a Muslim, yes.
Alhamdulillah.
You're a Muslim. Is that what you want me to say? Man. You're a Muslim.
Me too.
How can you condemn the Bible as a Muslim?
Is that right? Muslim.
The lies. Yeah.
How can you condemn
the lies of the Bible?
Wait, sir. I'm not debating you, sir. Wait. How can you condemn the Bible as a Muslim when Allah and Muhammad never had any problem with it?
Okay, first of all, that I have no problem to discuss this subject. Can you go back to Mark 13, 32?
I did. I answered it. I don't know what else you want.
You know what?
He's asking the same question.
Daniel, that's what I said. Daniel, you are speaking to me. Look, no one of the cameraman speaking. Except Daniel. There's no cameraman.
It doesn't matter.
There's a camera to you. Of course,
he's shouting.
He's still interrupting.
Okay, no.
They're still interrupting.
Were you not interrupting earlier?
Wait, Daniel, you said to me, correct me.
You got short memory.
Okay, wait a second. You said to me, Jesus was on earth, correct?
Sneakers, man.
And he had two natures. He had two natures, correct?
Yes.
His God nature on the earth. Was he perfect?
Yes.
So knew the hour.
He's God nature, yes, he knew did.
That. But according
but
to
he never said it because
carefully.
He was acting as a man. Like
I think it's clear. He just doesn't want to accept it. If you don't want to accept it, that's fine.
Listen carefully.
You were talking about interrupting.
We're moving on. The conversation is
according to Jesus,
he's not accepting.
Listen carefully. According to Jesus, was on the earth. You saying to me when he was on the earth, even Jesus as God knew the hour. But according to Jesus, when he was on the earth, no one knows the hour, only who? The Father. So therefore, Jesus as God, when he was on the earth, you claim he was fully, but he doesn't know the hour.
Okay, Shams, did I answer that question?
Yeah, but it doesn't make any sense.
God is above your intellect. So it's not supposed to make everything that's
okay,
so supposed to make
sense. Because God's above your intellect.
Excuse me? Are you running away?
No, I'm not, because that's your argument.
He's running away. He doesn't want to debate my topic.
No, debate your topic.
I won't debate my topic.
That's what I said to you.
We've all said
it. No, alhamdulillah, I clarify. Hey, I want to clarify something. That's why the Christians, they will never be able to stand in front of the camera and call into their belief. They always try to attack the Muslims. Because how is on
you
the earth?
You haven't seen our camera.
I see you.
You
never. You're always there. Muhammad this, Muhammad that. Why? Because
so
how is on the earth?
You
telling people
Muhammad,
that Jesus is God, but God died, God knows everything, God became a man, but he never became a man. Even the argument God became a man, he never became a man.
Nobody
because
ever...
he was a God. Again.
How can you condemn the Bible as a Muslim?
That's a good question. He don't want to talk about
his
subject.
Don't worry,
there's a lie.
Can I meet that myself?
Look, what is going to his email? That's what I got. This guy got anti-website, Islamic website.
My email is my anti-website?
No, you got
my email is anti-Islamic website.
I didn't say that. Look. I said you go to anti-Islamic website.
You're gonna get exposed, so just calm down. Is Muhammad from the line of Ishmael?
Yes.
Prove it.
Ibn Kathir.
Let's see it. Islam says Muhammad is from the line of Ishmael. Let's see some proof. You ran away from it last week, isn't it?
Your
imam is here now.
Yeah, of course. Brothers, what would I say? If I prove to you Muhammad from Ishmael, would you accept it?
You can't.
You can't. He's already made his mind. He's already made up his mind that whatever Muslim gonna try to bring us, I'm gonna reject it.
Show me.
Is there a point? No. Would you accept it?
No proof is.
No. Would you accept it?
Where are you gonna bring it from?
No.
Would you accept it? We accept it.
Are you asking? No. Are you asking me to bring from Islamic sources?
No. We're saying prove that.
I'm a Muslim, where am I going to bring it from?
You're from Islamic sources.
So who are you saying? He was Islamic sources.
Prove it.
From Islamic sources.
Good.
Yeah. But you accept it.
Why would we accept the Islamic source?
So what are you asking me?
No, we're saying...
No, because as a Muslim, you don't have it. I guarantee you.
You don't have it.
That's why you're running away. And you're asking red herring questions because he doesn't have it. Don't run away.
He's deflected.
No, we're getting somewhere.
Hadith, look, ishtabani. No, this is masakin, you know.
No, we don't have to move.
We have to move, brother. You want to run us over?
We've got space. Don't worry about it. We've got space.
It's three vans.
Hey, keep the circle.
Yeah. Alhamdulillah, I destroyed him in the oneness of God. Doesn't make it in your own mind.
Viewers decide.
We're all together in this, yeah?
What do you mean?
It's not about destroying anybody or anything.
I don't know who these guys are.
We're here to learn.
Do you want to get on the van?
It's a kind of destroy.
We're here with Dalil, like evidence.
Why don't you move around?
We're not here to take a personal.
You're a Christian?
We're here to all be one together. You know, at the end of the day, one of us has to go to hell,
isn't
it?
That's
where the problem comes. We're all here, it's all cool. You know what I'm saying?
Finding the truth. If you really love God, you'll see.
We'll get to that, you know what I'm saying?
So we'll find out if Shamsi's going to show us Muhammad is from the line of Ishmael. Let me just remind the viewers, Ishmael was from Egypt. Muhammad was from Mecca.
Ishmael was from Egypt. Don't lie. Ishmael was of Egypt.
That's what we believe.
So you're going to use your belief as a criteria for my belief?
No.
Look, we don't believe that.
Red herring.
Find it.
You know why?
Find it.
Prove to me. Bro, let me speak. Don't show me. Prove to me according to the Egyptian historians that spoke about Ishmael in Egypt.
No, don't change.
There is a war of words, you know.
They are arguing peacefully. We are learning.
You go from there, bro.
You know what I'm saying?
You go from there.
No, we have to go from there. We look to each other.
It's not a question, it's just.
They never get a war.
You're going off something palatable.
Did you understand?
It's a debate.
About the oneness of God. About Jesus and God.
How can Jesus be God if
you
didn't know they are
one?
No, because I know the hadith.
Islamic website. I know the hadith.
What?
Ask me Arabic, I'm sorry.
Even a Muslim doesn't understand Arabic.
Okay, the hadith. This hadith on authority of Wathiyat ibn Sa'd. The messenger of Allah. In Tirmidhi. Sahih Tirmidhi. The hadith authentic. Tell me.
I don't understand this. This is all Arabic.
I'm going to narrate it to you and just check it.
No. Show us in English because we will speak English.
Bro. I'm going to, you ask me for proof, correct?
Yeah, we have English audience.
No, I'm going to translate it. You don't have to.
No. How can we trust you?
He's running.
No problem. The viewers can translate.
No. We want it now.
No.
Because you're going to walk up like you want the debate.
No. You need a proof now. Because you told me, let the viewers judge.
Did you say that?
You've got to bring the proof.
Did you say that or not?
The viewers, they are English audience.
I'm going to translate for them then.
No.
From you.
From the hadith here.
How do we know?
Okay,
go.
Go on.
Go on and we'll interrogate him.
Don't let him get away with it. He'll say, walk off like a
good interrogator.
What I'm going to do now, I'm going to mention the hadith, translate it, mention sources, I'm going to keep it moving. Not for them, I want the Christian to become Muslim. I want you to.
You're going
to
go.
I will agree with you. Could you ask me for the proof? I'm going to give you the proof.
We need to analyze the proof.
Are you a scholar of hadith?
I don't need to be.
What?
Okay. Are you a scholar of hadith?
I study hadith.
No, are you a scholar?
You're not either.
So we're even.
We're not.
You're not a scholar.
No, you know why?
You're not a scholar of hadith. I'm not a scholar of hadith. We're even.
So we're even. This is
why.
Because scholars of hadith says authentic.
Okay, but you're not a scholar.
But you're not sure. You can't prove it.
But which scholar said? Which scholar of hadith you going back to?
Anyway, let me read it.
The hadith, the Messenger of Allah said, he said that Allah. Okay. Inna Allah astafa Kanana min wal Ismail. Allah has chosen Kanana from the sons of Ismail, and He's chosen Quraysh from Kinana, and He chose Quraysh from Bani Hashim, and He chose me from Bani Hashim. So Prophet Muhammad SAW is the son of Hashim, the son of Quraysh, the son of Kinana, the son of Ismail. Look at this.
You're gonna go.
Look at
running away. Typical coward.
He just
runs away. He reads his Arabic text. Who no one understands. 80% of Muslims don't know Arabic, and he reads Arabic and he goes away. We definitely know Muhammad was never from the line of Ishmael. It's a lie on the website.
Anti-Islamic website.
That's what it is. He went onto an Arabic website and he's like reading Tirmidhi. We don't even know where he's from. We know the Torah says Ishmael's from Egypt.
Yes.
And we know Muhammad was from Mecca.
Yes.
We know his grave. He's dead, buried, and gone. Mecca and Egypt are miles apart.
Who wrote the Bible?
He can't answer that question.
Who wrote the Bible?
Islamic Dawah team run away over and over again. We don't run away. We don't run away because Jesus is the truth. We don't run away from deception. We confront it in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Come to know the true Christ.
What's his name?
God bless you. Jesus.
Jesus.